That was so goddamn good, bro.
Oh, yeah,
he beat Spice. Oh, wow. That's my lad. Let's go, white boy. Kazuya, huh? Excuse me. Enough. Stop the shenanigans. Okay? Need some good, honest Super Smash Bros.
Honestly, I assume Mario will have a hard time in this matchup.
Yeah, of course. It's swords, yeah.
Sword, fast move, fast aerials. Character can get away with buttons.
Very, very, very
perfect. And you just have to be a lot of options like that, you know. Space.
Very nice combo. Mario can't
have options like space on it. Really cool. As long as he keeps Kurama space away, he should be fine.
Yeah, he's doing a pretty good job right now.
Twitter clip somewhere.
Shoot, I think we'll have a couple. That would have been dirty. That would have been dirty.
Is
he gonna tech it? No tech. No tech zone, Baron. What are we doing?
You have to tech those.
Gotta tech.
It's a multi-hit.
Nah, yeah.
You don't expect somebody to keep the Mario grab that a little earlier.
He's got those two. He's got ladders.
Yeah, the character has a lot of combos.
There was a period of time where people thought Aegis was like definitely going to kill this game, and now we're all worried about Steve.
Yeah, Steve and Kazuya.
Yeah, like Aegis, they're a very good character. Don't get me wrong, but you're still playing Smash. Like they are still going by Smash at the end. So it's not like, and I feel like they were a little overrated when that first came out, but I'm glad that we're seeing them a little more. Because they are very good characters.
Not very often when you see
we had Spearman playing for like some time.
Very good.
Oh yeah, most definitely. Okay, nice one recovery there. Oh, whiff grab. Now Kurama's up here. Let's see what the play is for this edge guard. Not edge guard. Left edge guard. Ooh. It's gonna be faster than the entire aerial. Yeah, man. Especially in that position, too. Very good string. This dude doing string. Tech situation. Catches the roll in. Very good, very good. Nice. Dashing away to grab it.
Oh, he's dead. He's dying.
Wow. I feel like he could have lived that, no?
Yeah, maybe.
It's a little sus the eye, maybe.
Kind of looks down at something.
Okay. Okay. We got those.
But Kurama, you know, top player, character specialist.
Yeah, one of the best Marios.
The best Marios.
If not the best right now, I think.
Possibly.
Nah, he's out of there now. Okay, he's gonna have to stop. No, he waited for the switch. Yeah, nice switch. Stuff from Kurama.
Yeah, that was so. Yes, that's sir. Such a good call out.
It's a very close game, though.
Yeah, honestly, games have gone either way. Down there, up smash.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and Baron giving the signal to run it back there. We're going back to PS2. Switch off after this time. I'll get back. They get me out of here. Watch it be like the hype is. Who's after these guys?
Mario. It might be.
We sink him out the ice. I don't think he should switch.
Oh, it might just start the other pool, honestly.
Both of them shaking their heads. Baron going Ike. I felt like the Aegis was going pretty good, man.
Maybe the Ike can do something different.
Maybe he's thinking, yeah.
Easier conversion. Nair. Fair. So I can see the problem for Ike is Flood.
Yeah.
Up the Flood, going down to Fair.
It's pretty dangerous for him offstage, because he's limited, kind of, in his recovery. He has quick draw, right? And then his upbeat.
Ooh,
let's see what the Texas Great roll in. Catches the rock. Ooh!
Tries to extend his combo with the...
Ooh! This shark in the water just waiting for your option. Drama is doing very good in this edge guard and left trap scenario.
You know, Blood is going to play a big part in this matchup.
Ike really has to mix up his recovery. Ah, yep. In order to deal with Flood, but there's really not a lot that he can do.
Yeah, like he tried to go over, but Flood's stopping.
Not killing this shit.
You know, the thing about Ike, he can't really go super deep to Ike like Mario or Peter. Like, you know, it's not like Adrian. So he can kind of throw out a hitbox out there. And, you know, Ike kind of has to take that shot.
Yes, dude.
Recovery's kind of not the best.
Going off first, going off stage is kind of like, hey, I'm so ballsy that I am willing to risk my entire stuff. Alright, we're gonna wait for the air dodge off. Just does it.
Ooh. Oh, he tries to hit him with
the Yep. I think you gotta hold out on that, but that's true on
like.
Yeah. I think the Aegis would have been a much better pick. Like, it was probably out of comfort, which makes sense, but it's also like you're a lot more limited, especially when he's off stage. Like,
the thing is, you know, you just had a close game one, you switch, and then you kind of start to play out this game, and you get help, and you're like, what would have happened if I would have just committed to this thing?
Right, it's just the oop.
Or might
just be the end.
Ooh! Try to call him, hit him there.
Yeah. Ooh. He's catching the roll in.
Oh, he's trying to hit him with S-Man.
Baron has a really constant habit of rolling in on these tech situations, but that doesn't matter. Got the juggle going on. Still got the juggle going on. Playing hot.
I'm doing the up smash of the shield, maybe.
Oh, most definitely.
Ike's kind of heavy. But a good up air from Ike could also take Marshall stock.
Most definitely. Oh, no. No, he's not even. Yeah, he is. Yeah, he's a heavy boy. Ike a heavy boy. And very good guy. Baron. Jump there. Good job. Let's see.
Kind of doesn't get back to stage.
He needs to space out his attack a little bit more from ledge because he's getting caught by Kurama's aerials coming off the ledge. Ooh! No, he held it. Good stuff from Baron. He's making this look easy.
Yeah,
like off stage, no problem. It is. Very scary stuff. Caught him charging. Hey, 186, no problem. Hey, yo!
I don't want to hit his shield or jump like that.
Let's try to catch him jumping, yeah.
Down here. But it's also scary if you're dropping because I have a lot of skill power, but this should do it.
Yeah, that's going to do it for him. All right.
Calls him out for jumping down here.
It wasn't a bad set. I feel like, as I said again, I wish Baron stayed with the Aegis because they were doing pretty good. If he had made some adjustments during that game, too, I feel like it would have gone a lot better.
Yeah.
Maybe a stage change. I'm telling y'all.